What should we do now? Before I start to talk about the new marble gate, I want to tell you that by the end of the video, I have 5 new announcements to make. So stick around for those. So, new marble gate, why? I am learning how to design things and how to design for simplicity and functionality. And throughout this project, I've been doing so many overcomplicated gate designs. They were all catering to the needs of the project at the time. And when the project needs are changing, also the design requirements for the gates are changing. So the last design was the pressure insensitive clock design, and today I think we've reached kind of rock bottom simplicity with this Pac-Man minimalistic gate. Also very encouraging is that this exact design is used inside pinball machines to feed one single marble onto the playing field. So this is actually an industry solution for a marble gate. If you think about it, a pinball machine is actually designed to work over and over again despite being maltreated by the angry players. When you design a pinball machine, you design it so you don't have to go out and maintain it a lot, because that will lose you a lot of money. So finally, I've actually come to an industry solution for how to feed one marble at a time. So now I have 2 good solutions. I have the clock design and I have this minimalistic design, and they have their own advantages, and I'm not actually sure yet which one I'm going to use. Perhaps even I'm going to use this simpler design for the cyber base, where the space is very confined, and this cooler design for the other instruments with the clock design, because from a complexity standpoint, they're pretty similar, and this minimalistic design is only a little bit simpler. If it looks to you that I'm just treading water, that's of course a little bit true, but it's not intentionally. I am on a path of educating myself to reach that understanding needed to pull this crazy complicated project off. This is how it is trying to build things. Look at SpaceX, another rocket went boom yesterday, and they have 100 updates on their SN15. Basically, it's the same exact process. This design is inspired by a design by Freubauter from Discord, which is here. It's an amazing design. And something from Florian, this design here. This design is theoretically only as wide as one marble. So it's the thinnest marble gate design ever. I noticed that the clock design was very loud, so I started to use these silicone tubes. So this design is made for silence. So on the whole design, there's not a single metal on metal, and it's actually really silent. What have I learned from building this prototype? First of all, these silicone tubes for dampening the sound worked perfect. It's silent, great. Secondly, I've tried to save material by using this 3-bar combination. Before, I used this 4 bars around the marble. And what I found out is that the tolerances needs to be very tight for this 3-bar to work. So I think I'm going to exclude this 3-bar design and use the 4-bar in upcoming gates. So this was the first prototype, and I just made it in metal by hand without cadding, and it worked out perfect first try. So already the first prototype showed me how promising this design was. Then I went over to make a second prototype, where I also tried some other features. And then I went over to the third prototype here. I started making the CAD design for this gate, and there's more than meets the eye when trying to design for simplicity. Simple is often harder. And then I tried to CNC machine metal parts on my CNC machine from Avid CNC. So shout out to the machine, because it's not really specified to machine metal, but with the correct toolpaths, I actually got a really nice finish of these metal parts. I've designed everything to be self-aligning for like water or laser cutting, so it goes together like a puzzle and I can weld it together. I'm sleeving the metal with this silicone tube. Silicone is super heat resistant and will dampen the sound a lot. Silicone is UV resistant and will not degrade over time. There's one problem though with the silicone tubes. I use them here for the drop off and it feels like they slow the marble down. It feels like the marble is kind of not sliding like on the metal, but slows down a little bit. So I don't know. It's much more silent, but I don't really like that the marble starts spinning and rotating if we compare to the metal falls. I CNC machined these bending jigs, and these bending jigs gives me the exact bend and also the cutoff points, which is very helpful. So I can just cut the rods off where the plywood stops. And this is of course not how I would build the real versions. This would all be laser cut from flat steel. So this is just for me to build this single prototype. On these templates, I'm also indicating the pivot hole, which is the pivot for this action. So I'm adding little lumps of metal, as you can see here, for those drilling locations. I'm gonna sand this down and drill this so it becomes nice. So now I've sanded down the extra metal and now I can drill from the back with a 2 and a 3 millimeter drill. This hole will be very accurate. I don't think I would be able to drill this hole more accurately than this. Let's see. So it looks pretty good. And if we put the two rods next to each other, we can see that the holes are lining up perfectly. This way we know they're accurate. 3 millimeter hole is for this M3 bolt. And the front hole is for this spring here. I like the small scale of all this. Despite some flaws of the prototype, and it took quite a lot of time to put it together, I can honestly say that it's such a reliable design. It just works plug and play from the moment I put it onto the machine. It seems like nothing can really go wrong with this design. All in all, it's a great find for the Marble Machine X, but I have to admit, I feel a little confused in my heart because I love the clock gate so much. So it's been a confusing kind of week. Somewhere in here is the key for the future of the Marble Machine X, definitely. Me and Wilson have 5 exciting announcements to make. Love Hulténs has done it again. Love Hulténs is a Swedish artist who just released the Marble Machine Extra Small video over at Love Hulténs YouTube channel. And this is just so cool. It's a Faberge egg version of the Marble Machine X. So head over to Love Hulténs channel and watch his video because it's absolutely amazing. Love has agreed to share some of the building files. So on the Wintergatan.net website, you can download actually some building package for the Marble Machine XS for free. Love gathered all the laser cutting files and also some technical descriptions for the Arduino programming to make this synthesizer sound. It's not a complete building instruction kit, but it's for free with the option to pay something. If you choose to make a donation for the free download, that will be shared between Wintergatan and Love. So just a huge shout out for Love. This is blowing my mind. Second exciting announcement is from the wonderful Marble Machine X CAD team. We have just made this download gallery available on our Airtable, which means that anyone can go here and download any part of the Marble Machine X you want. You can actually even download the whole CAD file for the whole Marble Machine X. I am pretty sure that this machine will never go on a world tour, but we're going to make a machine that will. So my plan is to finish this machine and record an album in the studio on this machine. While I'm recording the album, the idea is to actually overhaul the whole design and make something super stable and functional for the world tour. My vision is to incorporate the Wintergatan community in this process, have a kind of A/B design review process where people can submit design changes in 3D CAD. So that you can download a file and you can say, I've always been annoyed with how this is designed. It would be much simpler like this. You can present it for me. I can go through it in some live streams and slowly, slowly together, we can actually build the tour version of this machine. For everyone on Discord that are submitting so many cool design ideas, now you can just download the CAD for the part how it is, and you can sketch on top of it. Thank you to the amazing CAD team. I'll leave a credit link also in the description for this CAD team for making this download gallery and sharing it with everyone. Third exciting update, I made some whooshes. Whoosh, where's my, here. This is my magnetic stick. I made a whoosh special Wintergatan sound effect with the stick. You hear that? So I recorded 12 different whooshes from soft to hard, and I made it into a sound effect package that you can download for free on the Pay What You Want site on wintergatan.net. Announcement number 4. I want to apologize to everyone who sent in t-shirt design submissions last autumn. I received 500 suggestions and they were so great, and the Marble Machine X project took over. This is an issue I had. I start too many things and I don't finish them. So for everyone who are waiting for results, I personally want to apologize to you because you actually spent time, sent in so much great designs. My plan is to finalize this project this spring and show everyone your beautiful design submissions and make some nice new t-shirts. Exciting announcement number 5. Florian from F. Huable has made another video about the Ondophone. Florian is the genius designer who prototyped the Ondophone. I know there's some interest in the community to build some Ondophones, so I thought Florian's video came at a really interesting time. So check it out on F. Huable. So how do I summarize all this? I think what will happen is that I will use a mixed version of these two gates, the clock design for the drums and the vibraphone, but I will be using almost exactly this version for the bass, because I can't really get over the beauty of the wheel turning for every marble drop, and we have the space for it, and I can design this to be very reliable and very simple actually. So I'm in the same dynamics as I've been always. I get to 90%, which teach me so much things, so I realize I'm only at 50. And this JoJo pumping is going on at all times in this project. And what I really don't like is when people think that I'm kind of doing that on purpose. I mean, I am doing it on purpose, but not for the reason you might think. So to everyone who actually understands what I'm trying to do, I feel so grateful for having such an intelligent community around this project. It's a true honor, so thanks for being here with me. Thank you so much for watching, and thanks to everyone who are supporting this project through YouTube memberships and Patreon. Your support is amazing, and when there is not a video, it might sometimes mean that I'm working harder, like last week. Anyway, have a beautiful day, everyone, and see you in the next one. Bye!